The beauty of art may be in the eye of the beholder, but one artist from Greenwood Village knows that art goes much deeper than what's painted on the canvas. Community-based public artist Max Frieder grew up in Greenwood Village and began his passion for the arts at the Curtis Arts and Humanities Center when he was just 12 years old. Today, Max travels the globe, uniting art and communities together.
We are!
We are!
Artists!
Artists!
We are!
We are!
People!
People!
We are!
We are!
Kids!
Kids!
We are!
We are!
The
future!
So everybody is going to get a color, okay? And what we're going to do is I want you to start by painting shapes.
Oh, what is it? Just one shape.
And do another shape. And what we're going to try to do is get the entire thing covered in color. Then we're going to draw our idea of building the future for students.
I facilitate murals in communities around the world. I predominantly focus on working with communities who have suffered different kinds of trauma and mainly work on bringing people together through the act of co-creation. I am the founder of a network of murals that ends up creating a dialogue with different kinds of people from different parts of the world. So I've worked in 12 different nations globally, and the idea is that all these people can become part of this network through something called the Artlution, which is a website where all the different people involved can see the murals they've made, as well as other communities around the world.
Max's work stems from his leadership with the paintbrush in communities throughout the US, Israel, New Zealand, and Costa Rica. These experiences, Max says that they have made him strive into the world as a social catalyst for change.
How can arts be a catalyst? How can they be a facilitator for communication? And one of the answers that I've seen is that arts are a way of being able to bring out the universality in humanity. And that can be exemplified through the different ways that people interact through the arts. One of the most amazing ways that this can exist is through multi-generational forms of communication and multicultural forms of communication. So you can have all of these different people who have nothing in common, but through the act of a paint and a brush, as well as many other kinds of art forms, they can come together and be able to make a singular piece of art. The foundation of this concept really comes from the idea of having an entire community making art for themselves. So the Artlution, which I'm the founder of, is a network that's been composed of working with over 60 different nonprofits around the world, including different kinds of museums, different kinds of governmental and non-governmental agencies. Most recently, I was working with the US State Department. I was working with the US Consulate and the US Embassy in Israel and Palestine, in the West Bank, and then also in Israel. And the projects were really kind of founded on this idea of, can you bring people together in a time of war to be able to do this through making art? And the way that we were really able to do this is to be able to have people who were coming predominantly in a children's kind of setting, children and youth, to be able to come together and be able to make large-scale murals that be able to exist in those communities. This was during a time of conflict, during the last war between Gaza and Israel, and it was a specifically tense time in the region. And so being able to have this be initiated by the US government was something that was a really wonderful piece of public diplomacy to be able to exist in the area. Additionally, I've worked with UNICEF, which was in two different Syrian refugee camps on the Syrian-Jordanian border, one that was called Azraq and one that was called Zatri. And these were really founded on being able to get refugees, children specifically, who've suffered all different kinds of atrocities within Syria, to be able to make large-scale canvas murals that would be able to be cut up into different pieces and actually auctioned and sold at different large gallery openings, and the money would go back to be able to start art centers and have more arts programming to face some of the trauma that exists there.
It takes a village to raise a child. One of the groups that Max enjoys working with is children, which he says have taught him the power of respect.
So children, I think, are the soul of the universe. I think children are the foundation of what becomes humanity, right? The future. So if you're able to invest in children, hopefully that will grow into what the future of any community will become. I think this is especially important in places that have conflict and places that have trauma, and whether that be physical and sexual abuse, whether it be war trauma, or whether that be physical mental illness. I believe children are what will heal the world, hopefully. And one of the ways that I think this can come about is not just through the arts, but how the arts can be a sustainably oriented activity. So whether that means specifically through painting a mural, the idea is that if a mural is painted, for example, with a community, and then with a group of kids, those kids can think, wow, I had more talent than I ever thought that I could actually have. And then that can hopefully be a catalyst, a trigger for more events to happen in the future. So that they can think, wow, maybe I could paint another mural, or maybe I could do a dance, or maybe I could put on a play. And that this idea that they actually have their own power and their own agency to be able to make substantial actions in their own lives will turn them into the adults that hopefully will initiate positive reinforcement, positive healing, and positive fixing of some of the problems in the world. And I think if people invest in education in children, there's no greater value in the world than that.
Art comes in many forms. Creativity comes in many forms. Inspiration can come in many forms too, especially if it comes from someone like Max Frieder, who shows you that anything is possible if you open up your mind and your heart.
You take all these different children who've never met each other, these children who many people are thinking have nothing in common, who don't speak the same language, who don't share the same culture, and don't have many of the same traditions. All of those kids, in the end, were able to take a brush, put it to a canvas, and be able to paint. And one of the things that I think is really remarkable as far as that goes is seeing how children, many times, no matter what their circumstances, choose the same kind of images to paint. So whether that be people, or water, or food, or costumes, or animals, or environments, or houses, there's all of these different things that are pretty universal across all different kinds of people, especially children. And so my favorite has been seeing how all of these different networks, how all of these different people and these children have been able to come together through the single act and the single process of co-creation and collaboratively painting large-scale murals.